Welcome to the Fearless Agent Experience. Some of us have been through this before, and some of us were dragged here by somebody who has been through this before. Some of us took a wrong turn off the elevator. You don't even know why you're here, probably, but you're here, so we're happy to have you. And what is the Fearless Agent Experience? Well, it's what all fearless agents experience. That's what I want your experience to be. So I just want you to imagine that you're walking up the steps to your next listing appointment, and you know what every fearless agent knows. You know that it's a gettable listing because you set it up on the phone that way. By some agent, it would be gettable. You know you're going to get the listing, even though these people are total strangers. You know you're going to get it at full commission, and that would be a percentage that rhymes with heaven, but it's not 11%. You're going to keep 4. You're going to get a 1-year listing. You're going to have the seller begging you to underprice their house on day 1. You're going to sell that house for tens of thousands of dollars more than it's worth, and the seller is going to love you, and they're going to be sending you a steady stream of referrals because of what the great job you did. So that's what every fearless agent knows when they're walking up the steps to their listing appointment. And that's the way it was for me. But it wasn't always that way. Now, I got into real estate in 1984. How many of you are old enough to know? Okay, those are my elderly folks, great. So I got in, you remember the interest rates were 21% coming down off of, over 15% coming down off of 21. So I was a high school dropout, never went to college. My real estate car was a Harley, you know. I had a giant afro, so I was poised for success. I think you'd agree, right? So, but I knew that I would be successful in real estate. I knew I would be successful because I had a great attitude. How many of you would agree that attitude is everything? Okay, well, just goes to show you how wrong you can be. I failed miserably for 5 torture-filled years until something happened to me. One day, my broker comes to me and says, hey, there's this sales training event. He thought I had potential, I guess. So he signs me up, and there's a lady in my office. So she was about 6 months in the business, had no sales, no listings, no closings, no hope of succeeding, really. And we sit there in that sales training seminar, and then I turned to her and I said, where in the world have they been hiding this for 5 years? I go, this will work. This is it. And really, it was the first time I had ever been introduced to sales training in my life. So we signed up and took that course. 90 days later, she has 19 listings. She's the number one listing agent in our office at that point. And 90 days later, I had listings and sales and listings of mine that sold and closings totaling 50. So it was like overnight success, a little later than I had hoped, obviously. So we kept retaking that course every time it would come to town, and we didn't learn anything about real estate, but we learned everything about sales. So that's what we're gonna talk about today, because she and I later on joined up and became the top producing team of any size for Century 21 in the whole state of Arizona. And again, it wasn't about real estate, it was about sales and just taking care of the customer. So what we're going to do today is I just want to talk about some of the issues that are built into the real estate industry that I know you have noticed. I want to talk about why that even is, and then give you some nuts and bolts over the next 2 days. I want to talk about some nuts and bolts, tools that you can use to build your business, and then I want to have a little fun while we're doing this. So who's up for a little fun? Okay, great. It's not just me. So one of the observations is that, you know, I've been through a lot of business cycles in the real estate industry. So the market goes up, the market goes down. It's always been that way. It's always going to be that way. But for some reason, no matter which way the market's going, there's this tiny group of agents that they just keep getting better and better and better. In other words, they are market proof. So what is it that those agents do? It's not what they know, because we all know it. It is, what is it that they do every day that causes them to be market proof? And it's 5 things. The other observation is, you know, when I got into real estate, I said, I'm going to get me a real estate license. I'm going to get me a little name badge, little business cards, and I'm going to make a lot of what? That's right, money. But in a relatively short period of time, reality set in, and I thought, this is a little harder than it looks. And I use, if I'm famous for anything, it's my high-quality visual, so I'm going to share that with you. This is the welcome new member list for a local board of realtors for 1 month. So there's about 200 folks on that list. And then on the flip side, I just color-coded it. And that red group represents, statistically, the number of us that will not even renew our license in the first 2 years. We will fail out of the business completely. We will tie on the orange apron out at Home Depot, explain to our friends and family how that real estate thing didn't work out. Then the yellow group represents me. I did renew my license. People wondered, why did he bother doing that? Right? I was in a constant state of failure. Let's just say I was earning way below my potential. And I think a lot of the people in the room today that think they're doing okay are earning, I know, they're earning way below their potential. And then this little green group represents statistically the number of us that get into real estate, we knock them dead immediately, we have a, you know, we're earning an above average income, and of course half of them did it by marrying the broker, right? Or your brother-in-law's a builder, or your sister's a lender, you got some secret hookup that I didn't have. Not that I'm bitter, maybe a little, okay, but anyway, I didn't have that, so I was here. So what is it that the failing groups all have in common? And it is they didn't learn the five things. That's the thing. If you just learn the five things to make you market proof, so that's what we're gonna talk about over the next 2 days. What are we gonna talk about? Oh, five things, that's right. So, if you think about why is it that our industry doesn't help us? The stats are horrible. Our industry is not helping, and we get a magazine, y'all get Realtor Magazine. Our industry sends out a magazine. So in every issue of Realtor Magazine, I count up the number of full-page ads, full-page articles on two topics. One is technology, and the other is sales skills. In a typical issue, there's 10 or 11 on technology. I've never seen a single one on sales skills. Now, the funny thing is in my state, Arizona, it says salesperson right on your license. The funny thing is, on every sign it says for sale. This is the sales business, but our own industry is sending us a computer magazine. So if you think about it though, it's a very simple business. So we don't find ourselves in that many situations that we, so you might just jot these down. I think there's 10 or 11. One is you might find yourself sitting with some folks in their house, talking to them about listing their house to sell it. Then there's you're going to be having a conversation with doing a listing presentation. Everything I teach is presentation based, by the way, to make it simple. So another conversation we would have is about pricing their house effectively to get it to sell for way more than it's worth. So doing a pricing presentation. Then there's you're going to be having a conversation with some people that are thinking about buying a house, doing a buyer presentation. Hopefully getting them to sign a buyer broker agreement before you put them in the car and start driving them around and showing them houses. Then you're going to be showing the houses. So you're going to be, and there's a right way and a wrong way to do that when you're showing a house. So over the next 2 days, we're going to learn the right way. But the wrong way is the way they do it on every Home and Garden Network TV reality real estate show. That would be the wrong way. Then there's, oh, they fall in love with house, then we're going to take them back to the office and write up the offer. So there's a offer presentation, writing presentation. Then we're going to present that offer to a seller, your seller, somebody else's seller. So that's a presentation. Then, let's see, there's investors, there's for sale by owners, there's a couple of different ones. But I think that's about it, isn't it? So what if we had a great knock 'em dead step-by-step presentation for each one of those limited sets of situations we all find ourselves in? Well, you couldn't help but be making an above average income. And I would venture to say if you had just one of those, a killer, memorized, blow away your competition every single time listing presentation that you love, but if I had 100 average agents in the room, and obviously the average agents are not in this room, but if I had 100 average agents, how many of them would even have that one presentation? And the answer is not a single one. Why is that? Well, because the industry always has us over here screwing around on Facebook. They always have us over here talking about marketing, and we never talk about sales. So today, we're gonna talk about, what is it? That's right, sales. So what do we do about it at Fearless Agent? Three things, and I'd love for you to write these three words down: skills, schedule, and systems. Fearless agents have skills that your competitors don't have. We have a schedule where every day looks the same. And we have the systems put in place to make it all fun. Because the truth, if it's not fun, I'm not going to do it. And if it is fun, I am going to do it. So that's what we're going to talk about. What we're here to talk about today is you earning an extra $100,000 to $200,000 over the next 12 months. So whatever you're earning now, if you're brand new, you'd be earning $200,000 in this next 12 months. If you're not new, we're going to earn an extra $200,000. So that's our goal today. So I would like you to just take, you all have 3x5 cards. I want you to just write down what the pain scale is for you. Some of us are not doing 40, you know, I always give people a goal when they're brand new. If you're brand new in real estate, how many of you are brand new? Okay. How many of the rest of you can remember that feeling of being brand new? Remember that feeling of being brand new? You go, I don't even know what I'm doing here, right? And it was kind of refreshing because you didn't know what you know, the people say when you're brand new, you're unconsciously incompetent. Have you heard of that? And then you figure out what it is that you don't know, then you're consciously incompetent. That's when the pain sets in, right? So I want you to rate yourself. Then if you hang around a little bit, you become consciously competent. And then finally, you just know that you know, and you're unconsciously competent. You don't have to think, you just know. And then if you hang around long enough, like me, you become unconsciously incontinent. But that's another story. I don't want to go there. So I want you to write down the level of pain for you. So if 40 transactions a year or more, that's called no pain. Other than maybe you don't have weekends to yourself and your kids can't remember who you are, so maybe you have a little pain. But just write down, if it's 30, it's medium. If it's 20, it's moderate. If it's 10 or transactions or less, maybe it's severe. If it's less than 5, it's very severe, and none would be a disaster. So you rate yourself, and then later we're going to meet with our partners, our little accountability partners, and we're going to talk about that. So what is it that is holding us back from meeting our full potential in real estate? So I have a coaching student. Over the next 2 days, by the way, we're going to figure out what it is that's holding you back in every area of real estate. We're going to dismantle that, and we're going to make it better. And we're going to make sure you earn, over the next 12 months, a couple of hundred grand extra. But I have a coaching student. His name is Tanner. So he was 1 week in real estate a year ago, and then he starts coaching with me. So he's so new, he doesn't, you know, he's unconsciously incompetent, obviously. He doesn't even know what it's all about. And I said, well, you're so new, I'm going to give you a goal. I want you to do 40 listings at full commission over the next 12 months. So he said, well, I don't think I can do 40. And, you know, if you think you can't, sometimes you're right, right? Well, he was right. He did 120. He did 120 listings in his first 12 months in real estate. And there are many, many people who are 30 years in real estate that don't do that. So what was his unique ability? First of all, he's an ordinary guy. And, you know, ordinary people, he did an extraordinary thing in his first year. But ordinary people can do extraordinary things, and it's not who they are, it's what they do. So here's what he did. He said these words to me. He said, I am not going to have any ideas of my own. You tell me what to do, Bob, and I'm going to do it. And that is the magic ingredient. He didn't have any ideas. He didn't say, oh, I can't do this or I can't do that. He just did what I said to do. And if you do what I tell you to do, over the next year, you're going to earn way more than you ever thought you could. He never scheduled less than 6 listing appointments in a week. He never took less than 1 listing in a week, and that's the secret. So I gave you all 3x5 cards. I want you to just write down, if the money was the same, okay, if the money was the same and your skills were great at both and you could choose only listings or only buyers, but you had to do only one or the other, which would you prefer? So just you write it down. You're going to share it with your neighbor in a little bit. Now, I know that most of you wrote down listings. I know that because when you get into real estate, they say list to last, listings are the name of the game. So you wrote that down. But the truth is, if I went to your website, it would say search for homes on the homepage, which is all about buyers. That says, I don't care about the seller, I care about buyers. The whole industry is so buyer focused that the sellers are going disturbingly unrewarded. So we're going to fix that. I'm not here to change you, although I am. I'm here to change the real estate industry because we're off track. So if you're going to focus on buyers, great. I don't have a problem with that. I coach a lot of people who want that. But if you want to focus on sellers, we're going to have to do things differently than the industry is teaching us. So you've got that on your 3x5 card. Now, Michael Gerber, supposedly the greatest selling business book of all time, is The E-Myth by Michael Gerber, and the E stands for entrepreneurial. That's easy for me to say, huh? And I don't know if it's the largest selling book, but it's a great book, and it's on processes. It's a book about how to get it all done. So he talks about how in every industry, in any business, there's one number that you track. And if you get that number right, pretty soon everything else is going to fall into place, hopefully. So if you're going to do 40 listings in 1 year over the next 12 months, by the way, how many months are there in a, how many weeks are there in a year? Does anybody know? 52? No, that's not it. It's 40. Yeah, in a realtor year, there's only 40 weeks. And the reason is because we've got holidays, and then we've got your birthday, and then when we're done with that, I got to get you out of rehab, and you know, there's all that. So there's about 40 working weeks in a realtor year, so it's like a 10-month year. So you're going to do 40 listings, so it would be 4 per month. There's 4 weeks in every month, so that would be 1 listing per week. And then you're going to have to go on 3 listing appointments to get 1 listing. And then you're going to have to schedule 5 listing appointments because 2 will cancel. You'll go on 3 and you'll get 1. So I have listing coaching students of mine that do 160 listings a year. Just 1 person with 1 assistant. Most teams of 10 don't do that. So how many listing appointments do they have to schedule a week to do 160 in a year? What would you think? Just write down the number. So if it takes 5 scheduled a week to do 40, how many would you have to schedule a week to do 160? And the good news is it's 5. You still only have to schedule 5. What they've figured out, or what I've taught them, is a way to get fewer people to cancel, and their closing ratio is much better, and they're not getting 1 out of 3, they're getting 2 or 3 out of 3. They hardly ever have anybody cancel, and they hardly ever go on an appointment where they list with somebody else. And they're doing it all at full commission. So you're only ever going to have to do 5. So the number is 5. Now, the secret to hitting your goal is not to commit to the goal, It's to commit to the process. And what is the process of scheduling 5 listing appointments a week? So that's what we're going to commit to. So if you take your average sales price, write that on your 3x5 card, and then multiply that times 4%, because that would be your side on a listing. If you're going to do buyers, that would be 3%. And then you can do the math, and that would be your income over the next 12 months, excuse me. So I'm pretty good at predicting your income over the next 12 months if I coach you. I want you to just wrap your head around what we do for a living. Now, I'm going to have you share your goal when we're going to go to a break, and you're going to share your goal with each other, with your partners. Because, write this down, there is no plan B. Okay, so if you're going to do 40 listings over the next 12 months if you're brand new, or if you're off track and you're not brand new and you want to commit to that as your goal, I want you to know that there is no plan B. You're going to have to commit to scheduling 5 listing appointments a week because it's not going to happen any other way. There is no plan B. It's not going to happen. That goal of 40 won't happen, whatever your income goal was. So why 40? Because it divides easily and it turns out to be 5. So I don't want you to think my goal is $10 million in production. I don't want you to think my goal is, you know, $300,000 gross or $150,000 net after expenses. I don't want you to think it's the 40 closed. I want you to think 5. It's just 5. That's what we're committing to. And that's just the goal, but we're committing to the process that causes that to happen. So the truth is, everybody sets goals. The people that are successful set goals, and the people that are unsuccessful, they set goals. The difference is the people who are successful change their activities to meet their goal. And the people who are unsuccessful change their goal to meet their activity level, which they were unwilling to change. So when we talk to your partners, we're going to commit to changing our activities to meet that goal. We're saying there's no plan B. That is in fact what we're doing. So I was at a speaker event not too long ago, and I met this. There was this old guy, he was like in his 70s. He looked like very physically fit, kind of the opposite of me, basically. I go to the gym that has ashtrays on the treadmills. I don't know if you've been there, but it's low impact. But so his name is John, and he's talking about how he's a bicycle coach. So then he points to this lady in the audience who's also a speaker, and he says, and I train Denise. So then, you know, I don't know what they're talking about. So I'm out in the parking lot schlepping my luggage or something, and then Denise is out there. So Denise is 43 years old. Her name is Denise Mueller. She's a mother of 3. And I said, you know, she looks like a soccer mom. She looks fit. And I said, you race bicycles. She goes, no, I set the land speed record for women on a bicycle. I go, wow, that's impressive. I said, well, did you do that like riding a bike behind a vehicle to break the wind? She said, yeah, I did it on the Bonneville Salt Flats, and I did it behind a Range Rover. I go, that's cool. I go, how fast did you go? I want all of you to write down the miles per hour that you think she went on a bicycle. Okay, go ahead and write it down. The true answer is 147 miles an hour. Yeah, that's what I said. What? What? So I go, 147 miles an hour. I go, how, Denise, did you do that? She says, I didn't get off the bicycle until it went 147 miles an hour. And if you go to YouTube and you Google Denise Mueller, you will see a frightening video of her doing that. I mean, a couple of people have been killed trying it. So that's the way it is. How do you schedule 5 listing appointments a week? And the answer is you don't get off the phone until you have scheduled 5. It's just that simple. It's not going to be any different than that. I also said, when she said, she goes, I set the world's land speed record for women. I went 147. And she goes, and I'm going to set the overall land speed record for men or women. She didn't say, I'm going to try. She said, I'm going to, and that is 167 miles an hour. And that record was held by that old guy who was 70 years old. His name is John. So if I hire you to paint my house, you don't say how many brush strokes or how many buckets of paint. You just keep painting until it's painted, right? That's what I'm asking you to do. So the truth is, you have a choice in real estate. You got into real estate because you're an entrepreneur. You want to own your own business. And we entrepreneurs have something in common. We are willing to work 14 hours a day so we don't have to work 8 hours a day sitting in a cubicle like our spouses do. Like my wife, what is that, right? Who knows? But I am telling you that it is a 14-hour a day job when you own your own business. I don't know a single business owner that doesn't work 14 hours a day, and I do too, and it's a blessing. You're not gonna hear me complaining about it. But that's what you gotta wrap your head around. So you're gonna either work 8 hours a day, very hard work, and very low pay, or you're gonna have very long hours at very high pay. So the truth is, you know, Damon Runyon once said, the race is not won by the swift, nor the battle by the strong, but that is the way to bet it. And I do hope that is the way you bet it. Now, we're going to go to a break, and when we come back, we're going to learn what? The five secrets to earn what you're worth in this business. Thank you.